The family of James Maxwell's live-in girlfriend wasn't at all surprised when Port Orange police found human remains in his backyard.
Yeah, they say he bragged about killing, and they are afraid there may at least be one other victim out there. West 2's Claire Metz joins us live from Maxwell's home. And Claire, you spoke to the girlfriend yesterday. What's the latest developments today?
Well, I spoke with her briefly, as you mentioned, Stuart. She confirmed that she called police after getting information about a body buried in the backyard of the home she once shared with Maxwell. And by the way, she refers to him as ex-boyfriend. She apparently got specific information that alarmed her, and she called police. That led police to dig here. But Joanna Bertram's family, specifically her brother, says he told them horror stories about Maxwell long before that.
They were very afraid of him.
Alfred Bertram says his sister Joanna, we talked to her yesterday, was blind to the evils of James Maxwell. She wouldn't leave him. But Bertram says his family managed to get Joanna's children out of the house last August, and just in time, from what the kids said.
He would get drunk, hang out on the back porch, as they said, and would brag about how he killed two prostitutes.
Can you imagine to say that to girlfriend Joanna, much less her daughters? Then this week, the grim discovery. Remains of an adult buried here more than a year. Our sources have said the victim is a woman and the family of a prostitute, Chastity Starr, missing from Holly Hill since January of 2011, believe it's her. It fits with something else, Alfred Bertram says Maxwell told the kids.
He told my niece and my sister last time he had killed was in January. When he would brag about it, he'd say the last time he killed was in January.
Of 2011.
Yeah.
Which is when Chastity Starr went missing.
Exactly.
Bertram says he went to police twice last year about Maxwell's claims that he killed. But with no specific details, little could be done. Then, in December, Maxwell was arrested for kidnapping and raping a young neighbor. That eats at Alfred Bertram.
If they have found evidence to actually get Jim Maxwell off the street, maybe that wouldn't have happened to that poor little girl.
Back live now, Alfred Bertram says when Maxwell would brag about killing, he always talked about not one, but two prostitutes, specific to that number, two. And yet authorities say they only found the remains of one person here, which makes the family wonder, is there someone else out there unaccounted for, perhaps buried somewhere else? Reporting live in Port Orange, Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.